I want to speak to you this morning about the mark of the beast and of what we're going through with the COVID-19, of what people are so afraid of with the vaccine and what it can do and whatever. Now, I'm not here this morning to speak of the vaccine. I'm not here to tell you it's good or it's bad or whatever that is. That is a choice that you're going to make all on your own with the Holy Spirit as guidance. What I am here to tell you is that that is not the mark of the beast.
Amen.
That is what I want to tell you. And to make sure that you understand why I say so. So whether it has other effects, whether this vaccine has other effects, health effects, or whatever the case is, that's not what I'm here to talk to you about. That's your decision. I am here to tell you about the vaccine and what the Bible says.
Amen.
What the Bible says is true. The Bible is not going to say the vaccine that comes out on the 14th of February or during this month that it was, that comes into South Africa is not the vaccine for you. That's not what the Bible says. The Bible is going to tell you what things are pertinent to the kingdom of God and how we know where we are in the timeline of now and the tribulation period.
Amen.
So that is what I want to talk to you about. And I want to give you the assurance this morning that by the time I've gone through it all, you are going to understand that the vaccine is not the mark of the beast.
Amen.
Whether it has other effects, that's up to you. You have to go and do your research. But I can tell you with assurance that the vaccine is not the mark of the beast.
Amen.
It does not contain the mark of the beast.
Amen.
Because the Bible tells us exactly what the mark of the beast is going to be.
Amen.
And it does not have those attributes to it.
Amen.
Okay, so that is what I want to discuss with you this morning. And I've been doing a lot of praying, a lot of searching. I have, even as the Word of God tells us, sought the counsel of the wise. I have even sent out emails and sought counsel from people such as Pastor John Haggy, Pastor Perry Stone, who is the Fundai mentor, prophets in the area of the rapture, the tribulation, the end times. Okay, and so I have done my research with all this, and then this last week I saw something which actually sums up the whole of the questions that we have about the mark of the beast and the vaccine, and it said it so nicely. It's basically that I'm going to be telling you, because everything he said, he gave word out of the Bible, and what he spoke about was exactly what correlated with my heart, which gelled with me, and what I can say is true because of reading it in the Bible. Okay, so that is what I want to talk to you about this morning, the mark of the beast and the vaccine and the COVID-19 period. The stuff that I got, some of the stuff from, so you can go and look up Pastor Jack Hibbs, and also Amir Tesafati. Okay, he's a Messianic Jew. He has been a Messianic Jew for many, many years, for most of his life. And it's so nice to be able to hear when the Jews are Messianic Jews, in other words, they're Messiah Jews, they believe in the New Testament, they believe that Jesus Christ is the Messiah, that he has come to save us. Those that, where the veil has been lifted from their eyes, and they can see the truth. Because remember, the Israelites, the Jews, of God's people.
Amen.
So it's so nice, whenever you're looking to have a look at a timeline or have a look at events, you always measure it up with Israel. Mm. That is your time clock. When something stops in Israel, God's time clock stops. There was a period in time where all the Jews were scattered out of Israel. At that time period, God's clock stopped. And it started again when they all came back into, started all coming into Israel again. God's clock started again. And that is how we can see where we are in the timeline. Jesus said to us, nobody knows the date and the time when Jesus is coming for the second time.
Amen.
Back to come and fetch us. Nobody but the Father, not even Jesus knows, by the way.
Amen.
Only the Father knows the date, the time of the day that it's going to be. Nobody knows the exact time. But he says, but look at the signs. Because there are signs showing you where the timeline is and how close we are getting. So a lot of people are talking about the tribulation period. So the tribulation period has started because, I mean, this whole COVID-19 is a pandemic worldwide. Let me tell you something, the tribulation period has not started.
Amen.
Yet. Okay? But in saying that, I want to assure you, we are in the birth pains.
Amen.
We are coming up to the tribulation period.
Amen.
The birth of it has not yet started. But we are in labor, so it's very close.
Amen.
Okay. Now let me tell you another thing. Thank God we're not in the tribulation period.
Amen.
Because then you miss the rapture.
Amen.
Okay. Because the tribulation period is going to start when the rapture has just occurred.
Amen.
Okay, and I'm going to prove it to you. Alright, so I'm giving you these facts to... Oh, okay, I didn't realize this, so it's going to get your thoughts all focused on what I'm going to speak to you about this morning. Okay, we are in the birth pains just before the tribulation period. Now remember, the tribulation period is a 7-year period. In the first 3.5 years, the rising of the Antichrist is starting. Not when the 7 years starts, everyone knows who the Antichrist is. No, no, no. Halfway through, the Bible specifically says 42 months, which is exactly that, 42 months, 3.5 years. But the tribulation period is a 7-year period. Halfway, the Antichrist will make himself known. Halfway, you are forced to either get the mark of the beast or have your head chopped off. It says exactly that in the Bible. We're going to get to these verses. Okay. The first half of the tribulation period is a rising of four leaders, rising up and taking control. The Antichrist is not a system. It is not a new world order system.
Amen.
Yes, it can be the head of the system, but it is not the system.
Amen.
We cannot say we are in the tribulation period because we can see signs of a new world order taking place. The new world order system is not the Antichrist.
Amen.
The Antichrist is a person.
Amen.
And after the four main leaders start rising up, one will take dominance and he will be possessed by Satan and be the Antichrist.
Mm-hmm.
And he will make himself known after a 3.5-year period as the Antichrist, and you will be making a choice. Those that are here on earth during this time period won't be one of us. You will have to make a choice to take the mark of the beast or have your head chopped off. Okay, nothing is done undercover. You will make the choice to worship the beast. You will say, give me the mark, I want to worship the Antichrist. Can you see? Okay. It will not be done undercover and one morning you wake up and suddenly you have a mark of a beast. Because the beast, the Antichrist, wants your worship. And he wants you to proclaim that you worship him by taking the mark of the beast.
Mm.
It's not a choice to take a vaccine or not to take a vaccine. It's a choice to, yes, I want to worship the Antichrist, therefore, give me the mark. Okay? So please, before we get started with anything, make sure that you understand that. Right, there's chaos in the world today. Anyone agree with that?
Amen.
There's chaos in South Africa today. Anyone agree with that?
Amen.
There's chaos in the world today. Anyone agree with that?
Amen.
Okay. Then there could be chaos in your life today. Anyone agree with that?
Yes,
okay. Things are not going smoothly, nicely, exactly as they should be in your life perhaps today. That is where we are. That does not make it tribulation period. The tribulation period has certain aspects that are going to happen. And they haven't started yet. But we are thinking already about them. We are seeing things already that lead up to it. Okay. People are also considering that we are already starting the tribulation period because of all of this chaos. And people are considering and thinking that they're going to be tricked into taking the mark of the beast. You're not going to be tricked into it, people. Not at all. You're not going to be tricked into it. This vaccine is like any other vaccine that you got from when you were a child. This vaccine, I mean, I just want to ask you something. Do you remember when, some of you are much too young, when that barcode came out and it was put on the back of credit cards on stock and it had a 666 in? Who do you remember that? I'm not going to buy this. I'm not going to allow them to scan it. I'm not going to get near this because it's got a 666. I'm sure this is the mark of the beast. Do you remember that? The next one was, if we look at the credit card itself, it's got a nice little microchip on. You see that? That was another thing that came out. And people, whoa, I'm not going to use this. I'm going to work with cash only. I mean, this would be the thing. We've had a few steps where we've wondered. People who are not going to be tricked into taking the mark of the beast, you're going to know exactly what it is. They're going to explain to you this is what you're going to do if you get it. But let me take you one thing that the Bible explains very clearly. If you have the mark of the beast, you cannot enter heaven.
Amen.
Can you see why you cannot be tricked into it? You are physically going to make a choice because when they get to the 3.5 period during the tribulation period and now you have to make a choice, they're going to say, I can get a mark on the beast when you don't buy or sell. So you cannot get food. And that's only halfway through the tribulation period, after 3.5 years of going through hell on earth. And why do I say that? Because at the beginning of the 7-year period, the rapture is going to occur. And when the rapture occurs, the Holy Spirit leaves the earth.
Amen.
With us. And it is only the Holy Spirit that is restraining the Antichrist at the moment. It is only the Holy Spirit who is restraining the most evil at the moment, not you and me. Yes, we're doing our part. Yes, the Holy Spirit is working through us. But believe me, it's the Holy Spirit working through us. It's not in your power. It's not in my power. It is through the power of the Holy Spirit working through me that evil is restrained. And when we leave, the Holy Spirit leaves with us. And because the Holy Spirit leaves, the Antichrist starts. Yes! Now it's my time. You don't want to be here then. If you can't make it now, where you have the strength, the comfort, the consoling, the counseling, the power of the Holy Spirit now, and you can't make it, you're not going to make it then. You don't want to be here then. reason for need. It might be in camouflage, it might be happening within the next year, I can't tell you that. But I'm saying now, there is not an Antichrist in the position of an Antichrist. He might be born already. He might be in Parliament already somewhere. But he does not have the title yet of being the beast and the Antichrist. The beast is not a system. The beast is a person possessed by the Holy Spirit, possessed by Satan. The mark of the beast comes when you are already into the tribulation period, not before. And we haven't started the tribulation period yet. Okay? The mark, the word says, I'm going to read these scriptures to you just now. The mark, the word says, is on your forehead or on your right hand. That's it. Do you get the vaccine on your forehead or on your right hand? No. Okay? I'm giving you facts out of the word that explain to you why it is not. The mark of the beast is a sign of worship towards the beast. He doesn't want to have people having his mark that do not want to worship him. He wants those. That's why you get saved. The same is with the Holy Spirit. When you give your life to Christ, the Holy Spirit comes and gives you the stamp of approval. Because you chose to worship Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And he puts his mark on you. When you are reborn, you walk around, you can't see it, but the whole of the spiritual realm can see it. The whole of heaven can see the mark of the Holy Spirit, on you, the stamp of approval. And then Jesus comes even and he says, but do you know what? You're still there, you're not in heaven yet. So let me give you a deposit to assure you. And he gives you his Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit is the deposit of God himself in you to assure you you are full with him, you have everlasting life and you go to him.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. The beast wants the same thing. The beast wants to put his mark on you. So if he's going to wait for you to choose him, to worship him, then he's going to say, right, come. I'll give you my mark. It is a sign of worship towards the beast, the Antichrist. Believers cannot lose their salvation when they take the mark, because believers will not take the mark. Okay? A true believer who believes in Jesus Christ won't lose their salvation because a believer won't take the mark. Do you see what I'm saying? I'm saying if you make the choice to say, yes, I need to buy and sell, I will worship you. Beast, I'll worship you. Give me the mark. You weren't a true believer. You did not totally, with everything that is in you, willing to give up your whole life, believe in Jesus Christ. And that's why I say, believer will lose his salvation, because that believer never had salvation. A believer will be prepared in those days, because remember, there are births every day. So people are going to be born in the tribulation period.
Amen.
I'm so glad I'm not one of them. But they're going to be born in the tribulation period. And maybe, okay, most of them, they're born in the tribulation period, they're going to go to heaven anyway because they're children. I mean, it's only a 7-year period of time. But if you were left behind and you did not go up, make the choice to have your head cut off. And that's going to be the choice, because that's what the word says. He will give you the choice No person taking the vaccine today is pledging an allegiance or worshipping a beast by taking the vaccine. The Antichrist is a man who will be possessed by Satan. You will know what the mark is for. You are not going to be tricked into taking the mark of the beast. Satan wants you to acknowledge that you worship him. He wants it. That is what he wanted from Jesus when Jesus was in the desert. Do you remember that? All he wanted was Jesus, just bow down and worship me. I'll give you this, I'll give you that. And he had a right to give it to him because we had given it away to Satan. So when he said, I'll give you all of this land, he could have given it to him, but just bow down and worship me. You see, that's all Satan wants. He wants what God has. True love of his people that worship him. That's all that Satan wants. That's all he's ever wanted. Is adoration and acceptance and praise and worship for who he is. That's all Satan wants. That's all he's ever wanted. That's why he was kicked out of heaven, because he went against God the Father and said, but I am just as good. And the third of the angels worshipped him. And they were cast out with him. You see, that's all Satan has ever wanted. So he's not going to trick you into doing it. He wants you to do it openly. We will not be here when the Antichrist is revealed. When the Antichrist is revealed. As the Antichrist, right? Turn to 2 Thessalonians chapter 2. And I'm going to read to you from verse 1 to verse 8. Twee Thessalonians, hoofdstuk 2, van vers 1 tot vers 8. But relative to the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ the Messiah, so now we're talking about his second coming. And our gathering together to meet him. So we're talking about us rising up to meet him. Okay? The rapture. We call it rapture. Although that word rapture is not found in the word at all. They talk about in a twinkling of an eye we will be taken up and so on. And they talk about gathering together to meet him. We beg of you, brethren. So they give all these different ways that we know this is what's going to happen. But they don't talk about the rapture itself, that word. Okay. Not to allow your minds to be quickly unsettled. So please, don't stop worrying about it all. Do not unsettle your mind. Or do not let your mind become disturbed. Oh, I'm sure you're in the tribulation period. I wonder if I was missed. I wonder what I was doing now. I wonder this. I wonder that. I can see these things are happening around me. I'm going to, by the time we finish this, you're going to understand we're not there yet. We're in the birth pains just before it. Okay? Do not let yourself be quickly unsettled or disturbed or kept excited or alarmed. The apostle. church. I can assure you, in every church in the whole world, there are much less people. Do you remember what I've said right at the beginning about it doesn't, the people just don't persevere anymore because it just takes too much effort. And they're not prepared to put in the effort. Therefore, so many people are falling away because it takes too much effort. How many people should be here this morning that because of the COVID period have decided, oh, you know what, I'm not going to get all dressed up. I'm just going to watch an hour of God Channel on TV. TVN, Faith Channel, whatever. To say, why do I have to go to church? It's exactly what Satan wants. Don't make the effort, man. Don't make the effort. What does God's word say? Do not neglect the gathering of the saints. In other words, the getting together. Do you think God knows better? Yes. Because I can tell you, those people that are just watching something on TV on a Sunday, they'll do it this Sunday, they'll do it the next Sunday, then they'll miss, then they'll miss. Then they'll do it once again, then they'll miss, then they'll miss. And eventually, God is out of their life. God has been taken out of our schools. God is definitely not in our government. He is in so fewer places than where he was 10 years back. You see, there is the falling away of those who love the Lord. The church is becoming more empty, and this is just the birthing pains towards the tribulation period. This is what is expected to happen. So don't think anything's wrong with you. This is what is expected to happen. It says, the falling away of those who have professed to be Christians has come. It's already in progress. Okay? And the man, now this is going to happen before the rapture. The rapture happens before the tribulation. Only in the tribulation we're going to get the Antichrist and the mark of the beast. Okay? Are you all in that time? No. Okay. And the man of lawlessness, sin, is revealed. The Antichrist. So before the Antichrist is revealed, this happens. Okay. Who is the son of doom of perdition? Satan. Remember, Satan is going to possess the Antichrist. Okay. So before this happens, when he possesses this man and this man rises up, we're going to get the falling away of the Christians. Okay. Right. Who opposes and exalts himself, now they're talking about the Antichrist, who opposes and exalts himself so proudly. So do we know who he is? Definitely according to this, you're going to know who he is. He exalts himself so proudly and insolently against and over all that is called God. So he announces, he proudly blasphemes God and everything that is God and the kingdom of light. He proudly does it. All that is worshipped, even to his actually, eventually, taking his seat in the temple of God. You see, this happens in the tribulation period. Right? Proclaiming that he himself is God. He eventually sits in the temple in Jerusalem. He says, I am God. Worship me. Okay, we don't even know who that should be yet. Alright. Do you not recollect, do you not remember that when I was still with you, I told you these things? And now you know what is restraining him. Okay, now we get to the part. What is restraining the Holy Spirit of the Antichrist? What is holding him back? And he says, and now you know what is restraining him. to be revealed has not come out yet. Okay? Verse 7. For the mystery of lawlessness, lawlessness, evil, the mystery of lawlessness, that hidden principle of rebellion, rebellion against God, against constituted authority, God's authority, is already at work in the world. Okay, so what is happening now? Evil, rebellion against the kingdom of life. Is it already started? Yes, definitely. I mean, we have the rebellion. We have these standing up against God and those standing up against God. Not every knee is yet bowed. Okay? Is already at work in the world, but it is restrained. It's kept to a minimum. There's a boundary. There's a limit. Only until he who restrains is taken out of the way. And that is the Holy Spirit. You see, the Antichrist cannot be revealed there. And yet, the extreme chaos at the beginning of the tribulation period cannot start yet. Only until he who restrains it is taken away. And there's only one person that can restrain evil, and that is the Holy Spirit. And then the lawless one, the Antichrist, will be revealed. And the Lord Jesus will then slay him with the breath of his mouth at Armageddon and bring him to an end by his appearing at his coming back with us on white horses. Okay. So can you see where we are in this timeline at the moment? That's the first verse I want to read to you. It says that the one who restrains the Antichrist must first leave. Before the Antichrist can be revealed. And that is the Holy Spirit. We do not have the power to restrain evil. Have you ever tried? I mean, just look from that point. Have you tried to get things right? Are you hitting your head against the brick wall? Is that how it feels sometimes? We cannot restrain the evil in this world. Only the Holy Spirit can. Only he has the power. So when he is taken away, and he leaves where we leave, then the tribulation period starts. Okay? Right. Revelation chapter 13. Let's turn there. Revelation chapter 13. First of all, from verse 4 and 5, says, now, when you want to understand anything about the Antichrist, the beast, the prophet, that there's three of them, the Antichrist, the beast, the prophet, them three, they all work together. When you want to know anything about him, concerning him, you just go to Revelation chapter 13. It talks about the revealing of the Antichrist and everything in that chapter. So if you want to know more about it, you just go and read chapter 13 again and again and again, and you'll understand exactly. Okay. Verse 4 and 5. They fell down and paid homage to the dragon. Satan is often called a dragon. He had bestowed on the beast all his dominion and authority. Okay. So Satan had given the Antichrist all his dominion and all his authority, and people bowed before him and paid him homage. I don't know if you've seen people sometimes, oh, it's awesome to see you, and you pay homage. Okay, that's paying homage. Right. And they also praise and worship the beast, exclaiming, who is a match for the beast, and who can make war against him? And the beast was given the power of speech, uttering both. and says who he is. Okay, now there's a whole thing about the Antichrist, how he shot the head, he dies, he comes back to life, and all of this type of stuff. We're not going to get into that now. This 42 months is 3.5 years into the tribulation period. So the tribulation has started. We were taken away 3.5 years back. Now he reveals himself as the leader amongst the four leaders who predominantly lifted up in the world. Okay. Now he expects everyone to worship him. And then he is worshipped for a 42 months and 3.5 year period. Verse 7 and 8. He was further permitted to wage war on God's holy people. So were there holy people then? Yes, there were holy people who were prepared to not take his law. But he was permitted by who? By God. God's the only one that gives permission. He was permitted to wage war on God's holy people. Now, if you wondered about the saying of the 144,000 that the Seventh-day Adventists actually talk about, and they say there's only 144,000 going to heaven. If it were so, forget about it. 144,000 has really been chosen, you've got no chance. It isn't. These 144,000 saints are sent from heaven to come and to speak to the people on earth during the tribulation period, because the Holy Spirit isn't there anymore. So they say, God, when are you going to send us? When are you going to send us? And God sends them to talk about God, to be able to get people to still give their lives to God even during this period. Okay? So then he wages war, because there's still this murmuring. There's still these people talking about God and trying to worship him in corners and under in cellars and everything. And God gives him permission to actually wage war on God's holy people, the saints, and to overcome them. And power was given to him to extend his authority over every tribe and people and tongue and nation, and all the inhabitants of the earth will fall down in adoration and pay him homage. That is the Antichrist. Everyone whose name has not been recorded in the book of life. You see, if you were a Christian, a true Christian with salvation in that time period, and you missed the rapture, and you realized the rapture, and you rededicate your life to God, your name is written in the book of life. But you're going to have to make the choice to starve to death or to have your head chopped off. Because if you do get the mark, your book gets, your name gets wiped out. Effort. It's going to take perseverance if you're there. And everyone whose name has not been recorded in the book of life of the Lamb that was slain in sacrifice from the foundation of the world. Then we go to verse 16 and 7 to 18, and we read, and he compels all alike. This is the Antichrist. Both small and great, both the rich and the poor, both the free and the slave, to be mocked, with an inscription stamped on their right hand or on their foreheads. God would not make it so definite, so precise, if it could be absolutely any place on your body. He would just say there, stamped on their bodies. God is extremely specific, extremely detailed. So he tells you where it's going to be, so that no one will have the power to buy or sell, you won't be able to get food, you won't be able to buy, unless he bears the stamp, the mark, or the inscription that is the name of the beast or the number of his name. Then it says, here is room for discernment. the number of a certain man. His number is 666. Okay, the vaccine has nothing to do with that. We're not there yet. Okay. The beast will reign as the beast, as king, killing everybody and everything else for 3.5 years, the last part of the tribulation period. And they talk about the tribulation as being 7 years, but they're saying that the last three are the great tribulation. And you'll remember when we did the whole course on Revelation, we took a few months to go through every piece of what was happening. If you don't remember it, you can ask me to make copies of the CDs again for you. But we've been through the book of Revelation, through the tribulation period and everything. Okay. So, he will reign as the beast and king of all on earth for the last 3.5 years. And he will think he's invincible. He knows what's coming for him. He knows what the word says, and believe me, he believes what the word says. But he wants to take as many people with him to hell as possible. He wants to have his little moment of fame on earth for that last time period. You will first see the rise of the four predominant leaders, and then one will rise above the other after the 42-year month period. His colors will come out. It will be revealed who he is. Because you see, he's going to come as the Father of light, of goodness, of peace, in those first 3.5 years. I'll bring peace to you here. I'll bring peace to you there. I'm going to save the poor here. I'm going to make this right. I'm going to make that right. And people are going to think, wow, isn't this a good king?
Deception.
Deception. Because he is the Father of all deception. And in many places in the Bible it says, and he comes as an angel of the light. He isn't, but he can deceive you as well. Okay? The church is the vehicle by which the Holy Spirit restrains people. So we are still on the go, and we are restraining the Antichrist from popping up until the day of the rapture. We are not doing it in our own power, we are doing it by the power of the Holy Spirit. When we leave, the Holy Spirit leaves with us. Then is that time. We do not have the power alone to hold back evil. We don't. The Holy Spirit will then step aside. Then the Antichrist will be able to reveal himself. Then he will start coming out as this good person until 3.5 years are up. Then he reveals himself for who he is. John chapter 14. Matthew, Mark, Luke, John. Chapter 14. An awesome chapter.
Amen.
Verse 1 to 3 says, and this is what Jesus spoke, and he said, do not let your hearts be troubled, distressed, and agitated. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about the times that we are in. They must come. You believe in, this is what he was doing, believe in, adhere to, in other words, hold on to, and trust in and rely on God. This is what he tells you to do. Believe in and adhere to and trust in and rely on me also, Jesus Christ. Because I tell you, Jesus says, in my Father's house there are many dwellings. Homes. If it were not so, I would have told you. For I am going away to prepare a place for you. You see, the rapture time is coming, and it is drawing close, because Jesus left the earth over 2,000 years ago, and he went to prepare a place, a home, a dwelling house for each one of us.
Amen.
So, don't be troubled. to prepare a place for you. And when I go and make ready a place for you, it means that I will come back again.
Amen.
And I will take you to myself, that where I am, you may be also.
Yes.
That's what the Lord says. Jesus tells his disciples, don't get anxious, calm down. I'm in charge, rely on me.
Yeah.
I can do it all for you. Just trust in me. Read my word, see what I say, believe in me. And permit beheaded. For their witnessing to Jesus and for preaching and testifying for the word of God. Those who had been beheaded and who had refused to pay homage to the beast or his statue and had not accepted his mark or permitted it to be stamped on their foreheads or on their hands. And they lived again and ruled with Christ the Messiah for 1,000 years. The second coming of Jesus has birth pains before it. Now this is where we are. This is all to do with the tribulation, the vaccine, the mark of the beast, and so on, that I've read to you now. Let me read to you a piece where you know where you are now. Our timeline now. Can you see that we're not in the tribulation period yet? There isn't a person who has risen up that is causing peace throughout, that everybody knows of. There aren't four predominant leaders that have started yet. And most of all, the rapture, the Holy Spirit has not left the earth, so that evil can reign rampant. The Holy Spirit is still here. Therefore, the tribulation period has not started yet. Right, now where are we then? Matthew chapter 24. The last piece I'm going to read to you. Matthew chapter 24 from verse 3 says, while he was seated on the Mount of Olives, this was when Jesus was speaking to his disciples, the disciples came to him privately and said, tell us, when will this take place? And what will be the sign of your coming back? Okay? His second coming. Your coming and of the end, the completion, the consummation of all the age. And Jesus answered them, be careful that no one misleads you, deceiving you and leading you in error. For many will come in and on the strength of my name. Many will come and do miracles and stuff on the strength of his name, appropriating the name which belongs to me, saying, I am the Christ, the Messiah, and they will lead many astray. Has that started yet? Yes. There are people that are doing things that are actually evil. And you will hear of wars and rumors of wars. Is that happening? Yes. See that you are not frightened or troubled, he says, for this must take place, but the end is not yet, he says. Even when you hear this, the end is not yet. For nation will rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom. That's happening. And there will be famines and earthquakes in place after place. How many more earthquakes there are than normal? In funny places. Places that never normally got earthquakes. I mean, we've had a few, but we've never had earthquakes. And this is but the beginning. The early pains, the birth pains of the intolerable anguish. You see, it hasn't been birthed yet. Then they will hand you over to suffer affliction and tribulation and put you to death. That's even happening now. There are many Christians put to death for the name of Jesus Christ. And you will be hated by all nations for my name's sake. But it's not there yet. This is happening, but it's not there yet. And then many will be offended and repelled and will begin and desert him whom they ought to trust and obey. You see the falling away of the Christians. I've seen it with the bad thing. That's bad thing. Call me for my dear. And they will stumble and they will fall away and they will betray one another and they will pursue one another with hatred. Right? brother against brother, sister against sister, child against parent. And many false prophets will rise up and deceive and lead many into error, saying wrong things that aren't according to the word of God. And then, this is so true of today. And the love of the great body of people will grow cold. Mense is nie lief vir God nie. Mense gee nie meer om oor mekaar nie. Weet jy wat? As dit met hulle gebeur, dan gebeur dit van met hulle. Wat moet ek daarop tree? Everything is about me, myself and I. That's where we are now. Yes. Our people will grow cold because of multiplied lawlessness and iniquity, sin after sin after sin, and sin is so nice. So do you know what? I'd rather party and have a great time than go to church. Because church is an effort to party up and let go, man, I can have a few beers, whiskeys, whatever it is, and my worry.
It's worse.
Go away. So it's less work, no effort. I can sleep around out of it, getting married. Marriage is effort at its best. Because then I don't worry about my husband. What is he like? What does he want to do? I've got to make him food. I've got to do his washing. I've got to keep the house clean for him. Otherwise,
thank you.
Okay. Good. God is good. And God is with us. Amen.
Amen.
Let's stand.